What's going on, Leafer Nation? It's Leafer back again, and welcome back to another NHL 20 news video. And today, EA has tweeted out the first gameplay trailer for NHL 20. So in this video, what I will be doing is breaking down the trailer with you guys and just giving my thoughts on the trailer as a whole. So let's get right into it.
With the introduction of RPM Tech in NHL 19, we delivered a revolutionary new skating engine that overhauled control and responsiveness in our skating. In NHL 20, we're using the same cutting-edge technology to deliver RPM Tech benefits to the stick, resulting in unprecedented improvements to shooting, puck pickups, upper and lower body fluidity, and goaltender animation. Thanks to RPM Tech 2.0, NHL 20 now looks, feels, and plays better up and down the ice.
What they're talking about here is the RPM Tech 2.0, and what you can see is the shooting looks so much more realistic. They showed a little bit of the goalie animation, and now they're going to be talking about the signature shots.
In NHL 20, with a complete overhaul to shooting animations and introduction of signature shots, every shot is different. Signature shots showcase the unique styles and attributes of individual players. Whether you're Austin Matthews setting up a toe-drag wrist shot, PK Subban with the high wind-up booming slap shot, or Ovechkin with the seamless one-timer, you'll be able to feel like a superstar and snipe like one too.
So they're saying a lot of the players have their signature shots in the game, whether it is Sagan from where he shoots that one-timer, Matthews, how he toe-drags it, which is very cool. They're making the game more realistic, and it's definitely going to be better to play. It looks like a faster game, and as you can see, this is actual footage, actual gameplay from NHL 20, just with some cool camera angles and stuff like that. But it is actual gameplay, and it does look way smoother, way more realistic, and way more faster.
In addition, RPM Tech allows us to add contextual shots, giving you realistic animations in any circumstance. In NHL 19, shot animations lacked full coverage, meaning players took unrealistic or ineffective shots. In NHL 20, contextual shots allow the player to take the correct shot in the correct situation by taking into account multiple factors, including distance from the net, puck placement, and movement coming out of dekes. Imperfect passes will force the player to have to readjust, reducing accuracy and strength, where precise passes will result in a powerful, accurate shot. Contextual shots will reward better body positioning, timing, and twitch skill, allowing for more fulfilling and realistic gameplay.
Next thing they talk about is the contextual shots. As you can see, the shots look way more realistic than they were in NHL 19. In NHL 20, it looks like more realistic shot animations. When you're shooting from an off angle, it'll be a more realistic shot than a weaker shot as compared to NHL 19. As you can see in 19, some of the shots that they are showing you, the weak backhand, sometimes they're missing on the one-timers where they should be set up better. And that, for me, that was very frustrating to play in NHL 19. But in NHL 20, it is definitely different. You see players making the right adjustments to make the right shot selection, leading to better chances and more goals. The fact that the players adjust themselves to the puck, they know what is the better shooting selection for the better chance, the better scoring opportunity, is just amazing. And it's very cool to see EA, know where they went wrong and now add that. So what you can see with the Brinkhead there, instead of using his forehand to try to one-tee it, he goes on his backhand and taps it in. In NHL 19, 100%, I guarantee you the player would have went for a forehand one-timer and completely whiffed on the puck. But in NHL 20, as you can see from that clip, the Brinkhead uses his backhand to scoop the puck into the net, which is very cool. And I'm very excited to see it actually work in the gameplay, and I'm just happy that they made a change with that.
RPM Tech also adds another level of responsiveness to gameplay through explosive transitions. In NHL 19, a player would enter a glide and lock trajectory when receiving the puck, forcing the player to slow down or lose responsiveness. In NHL 20, explosive transitions allow you to take the puck in stride, anticipate a turn before receiving the puck, and retain your speed, allowing every player to make plays in motion, just like NHL superstars.
So next they talk about the explosive transitions added into NHL 20, and they show some gameplay from NHL 19 where a player would get a pass and they would kind of lock up, trying to make the pass, stop up, and then start to skate again, which would make the gameplay slower. But it forces the player to slow down and make the wrong play, easier for your opponent to kind of grasp where your player is going to go and take the puck off of you. On NHL 20, with the explosive transitions, they're saying your player will know once you make the turn with the puck before he even gets the puck. It allows you to take the puck in stride as well, and it allows you to retain your speed while getting a pass from the other player, which is very huge. This will make the gameplay faster, look more smoother and cleaner, and more realistic. So it's very cool. I'm very excited that they added the explosive transitions. It looks so much better than it did in NHL 19. And this gameplay trailer has been looking very good so far, and I'm very excited for NHL 20, to say the least.
We've heard your feedback, and we've raised the game for goalies. In NHL 19, goalies did not have the expansive tool set to control the puck, too often resulting in soft rebounds and scoring chances. In NHL 20, goalies in position and in control will have the ability to take over the game with all new controlled saves, redirects, and a whole new suite of covers. Additionally, AI goalies are more aware of threats on the ice, impacting their positioning and how they handle the puck. With the addition of RPM tech to the stick, explosive transitions, and all new tools for goalies, NHL 20 delivers the most responsive and realistic gameplay the NHL franchise has ever seen, making the game feel better, play better, and look better.
Next thing they talk about is intelligent saves, and it starts off with them showing gameplay from NHL 19 where you're taking low shots and your goalie isn't too good at redirecting the puck out. It will just leave a big rebound out for the opponent to get, and eventually either get a very good scoring chance or the puck end up being into the back of the net. So in NHL 20, goaltender AI will have the ability to redirect the puck. If they are in perfect position, they will not be giving out a huge rebound like they did in NHL 19. They will be redirecting the puck with their blocker, with their stick, out into the corner instead of in front of the net. They also show that goalies are better with cover-ups, which is definitely huge. They're more realistic cover-ups in NHL 20 than they were in NHL 19. But you can just see the difference in goaltender animations with the redirection of the pucks, the cover-up animations from the trailer, and it looks super clean, super realistic, and I'm happy that they added these new animations into the game. That looked really cool with Eberle grabbing a stick back and bringing the puck towards him. That looks very cool. So it looks like even when the puck's behind him, they have the intelligence to pick that puck up from behind them and bring it to the front instead of letting the puck just go and then just continue to skate, which was a big issue in NHL 19. So that is the trailer. We went step by step on what they were talking about, and honestly, after watching that trailer a couple times, I can say I'm very excited for the game. This gameplay does look very, very promising to me, and a lot of people say this every year, the trailer looks very promising, but this year, man, I'm telling you, with the new pickups, the new goaltender animations, the signature shots, all these new things they were adding are very huge parts to the game that will make the gameplay faster, more realistic, and honestly more fun to play. So guys, I want to know your thoughts on the trailer. Honestly, let me know what you guys think about this trailer. Be brutally honest in the comments. I want to know what you guys think. Personally, I am super excited. EA is going in the right direction with adding these signature shots. The puck pickup animations look very better. It looks smoother, very clean. The goaltender animations look way better as they can redirect the puck, so it will lead to less turds. You know, that was a huge thing in NHL 19. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and that is going to be it for this video. Also, guys, before I end off on this video, there is a pre-order offer that NHL is offering. If you guys are big on Hutt and want a free 85 overall card to start off Hutt with in NHL 20, make sure to pre-order the game before July 18th. The link will be in the description below. Go and pre-order it if you want a free 85 overall Hutt card in NHL 20. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this video. If you guys did enjoy the video, make sure to drop a like. And remember, drop a comment down below on what you guys think about this NHL 20 trailer. Also, if you guys are new around here, make sure to hit the subscribe button. We are inching our way closer to 2,000 subscribers. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!